The for each loop is going to iterate over the output data that was created from the extract data from web page. This is a data table, and we're going to click on save. So inside of these actions, we are going to add the extract, more extract data from the web page. So let's go back to our recorder and let's get all of the information that we want. So let's record this and let's hover our mouse over all of the different elements that we want to extract. So let's get the heading. Let's get the location. And also let's get the entire job description. So we can also get maybe this link right here. And for the sake of this example, we're gonna stop right here, but by continuing, you can just select all of the different elements and that you are interested in extracting. So we are going to click on done with our recorder, and this is going to generate a few steps. Now we don't need, we're going to delete all of the steps that we don't need. By holding shift and clicking around, you can select all of the different actions that were created. We are going to be left with extract data from web page. We're going to put this inside of our loop, and our automation, ladies and gentlemen, is almost complete. Not even a little bit more over than 5 minutes. We have done this live, and just that's just how to show you how easy and simple this is to use and to learn. So let's add one more action, and that action is going to be to navigate to a page. So or go to. So we are going to go to a web page, and that web page that we're going to go to is going to be the current item. What do I mean the current item? If you remember, we are extracting the data here, all of the links that we want, all of these 200 links, and we are then looping through all of these 200 links. Now, the current item is the item that we are currently going through right now. Let's try this and see what happens. One last part that is missing is that we are missing to add this data onto an Excel sheet, but we can do that in just a couple of minutes as well. Let's test this first part of the process and see if it's working. So it has extracted all of the jobs. Now it's going through the different pages, the first one, the second one, and so on. So this is pretty much working. We can see that in the output data, we have extracted the information, but with every new loop, we lose the information. And also the information is not being put on an Excel sheet. So what we're going to do is we're going to type in Excel inside of our actions, or we can search for it inside of the actions pane. So we're going to launch a new Excel, and we're going to do that outside of our loop, a blank document in this example, and just save it. After that, we are going to add the get first column row from the Excel sheet, and we're gonna put this at the end of our loop. So let's save this, and what this is going to do is going to help us once we write the information inside of the Excel sheet. So the next step is going to be to write to the Excel worksheet, and the values to write, we are going to write the values that are output data. The output data 2 is the values that we have extracted, and they are right here. And where we are going to write them, we're going to write them in column A. And in the row, we are going to add the first free row. This is going to know that it is going to write in the following, in the following, in the following, in the following row. So let's click on select, and this is pretty much done, ladies and gentlemen. Our process maybe might need a little bit of fine tuning, but it should be pretty ready. So remember also that I'm doing this live, so I'm testing this and doing this live with you, so you can see that we haven't had any issues, bugs, or any kind of problems so far. So we've just in over 10 minutes, we have almost completed the entire process. Now, while we wait for this, I just wanna thank you all for watching the RPA Champions channel. Without you guys, and without you liking and commenting on my videos, I wouldn't be making this. So thank you so much. Please feel free to ask me whatever you feel like in the description, and I will try to get back to you as soon as I can. or maybe even make a video about your request. Now let's magically open our Excel sheet and see what we have in here. So we can see that we have the first row, the second row, the fourth row, the fifth row, sixth, seventh, and as we continue, we can see that it's inserting more and more rows, copying all of the information that we said we would do. Now, that is it, ladies and gentlemen. I hope that you have enjoyed this video. I have also left a link to get the code of this process, should you choose to experiment and play around with it. And also remember, use this technology with caution and with good reason and good intent to save you time, mainly. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video.